इंटीग्रल डीएक्स अपॉन एक्स प्लस टू इंटू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इज गिवन ए टाइम्स लॉग ऑफ वन प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी टैन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस वन अपॉन फाइव लॉग ऑफ मॉड ऑफ एक्स प्लस टू प्लस सी. देन वी नीड टू फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए एंड बी. सो लेट्स कंसिडर लेफ्ट साइड एल एच एस इंटीग्रल डी एक्स अपॉन एक्स प्लस टू इंटू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन. लेट अस यूज इट बाई पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस. Let us solve it by partial fractions. So 1 upon x plus 2 into x square plus 1. We can write it as a upon x plus 2 plus bx plus c upon x square plus 1, since x square plus 1 is irreducible. So which equals to a times of x square plus 1 plus bx times of x plus 2 plus c times of x plus 2 upon x plus 2 into x square plus 1. Now in comparing both the sets, so you may have 1 is equal to a times of x square plus 1 plus bx into x plus 2 plus c of x plus 2. Now put x is equal to minus 2. X is equal to minus 2. So which implies 1 is equal to a times of minus 2 whole square is 4, 4 plus 1 that is 5 plus b into minus 2 plus 2 that is 0 plus c into minus 2 plus 2 that is 0 again. So from here we can just conclude that 5 times a is equal to 1 or a is equal to 1 by 5. Now comparing the coefficient of x square on both sides. Comparing coefficient of x square. Both the sides will have, on left side there is no x square term, so 0, which is equal to here x square terms a here and bx into x that is b plus b. That's only two terms are there. A plus b equals to 0. And since a is equal to 1 upon 5 or a plus b is equal to 0 implies a is equal to minus b or b is equal to minus a. So which implies b is equal to minus 1 upon 5. So you got the value of a 1 upon 5 and b is equal to minus 1 upon 5. Now let us find the value of c. So by comparing the constants on both the sets. Now comparing constants. Comparing constants on both the sides. So we'll have 1 is equal to here a into 1. There is one constant and here there is no constant. And coming to the third term, c into 2, that is 2c. So which implies 2c is equal to 1 minus a. A is nothing but 1 upon 5, that is 4 upon 5. So which implies c is equal to 4 upon 5 divided by 2, that is 2 upon 5. So finally we got it, constants a is equal to 1 upon 5, b is equal to minus 1 upon 5 and capital C is equal to 2 upon 5. So let us substitute in the partial fractions. Therefore we have integral 1 upon x plus 2 into x square plus 1 dx, which is equal to integral of a upon x plus 2 and bx plus c upon x square plus 1. So let me write that a upon, what is a? A is equal to 1 upon 5. So 1 upon 5 times of x plus 2 dx plus integral of bx plus c, that is minus 1 by 5x plus c is equal to 2 upon 5 of upon x square plus 1 dx. So let us simplify this now, which equals to 1 upon 5, integral 1 upon x plus 2 is log of mod x plus 2 plus, and here we can take out 1 upon 5 common, and also we can write here minus first, minus x upon x square plus 1 dx integral, and again plus here 1 upon 5 or 2 upon 5 integral 1 upon x square plus 1 dx. So 1 upon 5 log of mod of x plus 2 minus, and here we can just multiply and divide with 2, so that we'll get here into 2 and into 2. So 2x, let me take it inside. So differentiation of x square plus 1 is 2x. So it is in the form of f dash by f. So f dash by f integration is nothing but log of f, log of f of x. So we can write here 1 upon 10 log of x square plus 1, and here again 2 upon 5, 1 upon integration, 1 upon x square plus 1 integration is tan inverse of x. So plus 2 upon 5 tan inverse of x plus integral constant c. So finally we got, and when comparing with the RHS of the given equation, so a times of log of 1 plus x square, so let me write here, a times log of 1 plus x square, and again plus b tan inverse x plus b tan inverse x plus again 1 upon 5 log of x plus 2, 1 upon 5 log of mod x plus 2 plus c. So when comparing these both, log of 1 plus x square, so we're getting a is equal to, so when comparing, a is equal to minus 1 by 10 and b is equal to 2 upon 5. So we can go with an option a is equal to minus 1 upon 10 and b is equal to 2 upon 5. That's the third option. Option C is the right answer. Okay, thank you. And this problem can also solved by differentiating other method. Differentiating with respect to x on both the sides, and then compare, simplify and compare it. So we'll get the values of A and B. Okay. Okay, thank you.